Hi, and welcome back to VSDC channel. Today we're going to show you how to quickly apply a motion blur effect. Motion blur effect often occurs naturally, both in photos and videos, when objects are moving faster than a camera can capture. It's especially common if you're shooting at a low frame rate. However, you can also add motion blur to your video, image, or text during post-production. Before we move on, here's a quick heads up. The result of the motion blur filter in VSDC will look like this. If you're looking for something that looks like this, we call it a visual echo filter, head over to the top right corner because it's a different effect and a different tutorial. Now, without further ado, let's get started. Launch VSDC and add your footage to the scene. If you want to apply the effect to the entire video, leave it as is. If you want to apply the effect to a piece of a video, split the footage to separate that fragment. Here comes the tricky part. If your object in the video is moving, and it's important for you to keep it in the focus, we recommend using motion tracking. It's a premium feature, but it's the only way to make the motion blur filter follow the object. Applying motion tracking is pretty easy in this case. Just make a right mouse click on the video and select Create Movement Map. Then let the software draw the movement trajectory. Save it and go back to the main timeline. Find the tool named Tracking Point on the left toolbar and place it over your moving object. Excellent! Make a double click on the tracking point layer and add the movement map you've just created. Now it's finally the time to apply motion blur. Proceed to Filters and select Motion Blur. To adjust the effect, you'll need to tweak a few controls in the Properties window. For starters, you can choose one of the three available motion types: linear motion, radial motion, zoom motion. You can also adjust the intensity of the effect by changing the blur distance or angle. The former defines the length of blur streaks, and the latter defines their angle. Each motion type has at least one of these parameters available, so you can just go ahead and start playing around. The cool part is that you can also make the effect increase or decrease over time. To do that, expand the blur angle or blur distance menu and type the initial and final values. For example, if you set the final value higher than the initial value, the video will be getting blurrier over time, which is a great approach for transitions. Notice that for radial motion and zoom motion, you can also move the center of the effect and control the area that stays in focus. And just like that, you can add a beautiful motion blur effect to your videos for free using VSDC Video Editor. You can apply it to the entire video, a short fragment, a title, image, icon, or shape. Leave your questions in the comments below. And don't forget to download the latest version of VSDC. Until next time!